In today's video, I'm gonna aim to give you an idea of what kind of steps you need to take in order to become a faster and better Speedcuber. Hi, the Epicuber Andrew over here, and welcome to my channel. And over here on my channel, I do a bunch of Rubik's related content. And I just recently also started doing some cinematic stuff, so definitely check it out if you're curious. And let's get into the video. In the Speedcubing tutorial, I'm going to cover the overall strategy in order to get faster at cubing, not the details, since that will take hours to complete. So instead, I'll link a bunch of videos that are really helpful in the description. So definitely check it out over here. Okay, below me, check it out. Okay, and also watch the end of the video, since I will present three really helpful tips that can really excel your speed. So first of all, if you haven't learned notation before, learn it, link in the description below. And even if you have learned it before, I will strongly recommend you to learn it, since there's a lot of variations between notation and it can be confusing. So definitely check it out. Second of all, if you are a beginner and you're still using some beginner method, learn CFOP or CFOP, and video in the description below. And the reason why you want to learn CFOP is because that CFOP is an advanced method and it's really developed. That means you're going to get a lot of tutorials and videos covering it, and you can get really, really fast with it. So definitely learn CFOP. However, for the time being, do not learn F2L, okay? F2L is a really hard thing to learn. And that brings us to our third step, inspection. And in fact, you can start doing inspection when you learn to cross. And what inspection means is you're going to look at your cube before you start to solve and map out what you're gonna do. And probably like know how to do the cross. And that makes you way faster. And video in the description below again. And now onto the fourth step. And now you can start learning some F2L. So learn the intuitive F2L, and that's gonna make you like way faster since you can do two layers at a time. That's amazing, right? So again, video in the description below. And after you get comfortable with F2L, now you can move on to Tulik OOL and Tulik PLL. And for Tulik, that means that you can do it in two steps. So two steps and OOL done. Same for PLL. And for ALK, you always want to learn the best ALK possible for yourself. So you want to look at all the ALKs and see which one's best for you. And I'm going to link a couple websites and resources and videos in the link below. So check it out in the description, okay? And now, if you learn everything up to this point, you may be a little bit confused. Like, I'm still at 30 seconds. Should I be around like 20 now? Like, there's so much stuff I learned. And that brings us to our fifth step, okay? Look ahead and even more inspection. And for look ahead, it's essential for you to get familiar with all your ALKs and get into your muscle memory so you're not focusing on what you're doing right now, since that's not gonna help with your look ahead, but rather focus on what's coming up. So make sure that you're actually focusing on what's coming up, okay? That's really important. And for training look ahead, there's two ways generally. And one is called slow solves, but I like to call it smooth solve. And the other way is just to memorize pairs and solve them at the same time. So probably like two pairs at the same time. And I'll link it in the description below, both methods, okay? And now you have been practicing a lot on look ahead and your F2L is kind of fast. However, there's still kind of a problem. Like when you're doing your cross and transition to F2L, you kind of have a awkward moment where you just pause a lot. So now you want to also remember the first F2L pair or do something like called X cross. Okay, X cross means you solve the cross and an F2L pair. So I'll put videos in the description below that will teach you both steps. And on to the seventh step, even more F2L, OOL, and PLL ALKs. And then you can also do some, you know, F2L. So try to learn F2L from different angles. And here's a resource from JPerm, and JPerm does it really well. So definitely check it out in the description below. And also learn all the PLs. There's only like 21 cases, so it should be an easy start. And remember to find the best out for you. And also learn how to finger trick it properly. When you get comfortable with all the PLLs, you can move on to the OLLs. And when you learn the OLLs, also find the best alg possible for yourself. And remember to finger trick all the algs. And on to the final step. And for the final step, it's actually kind of flexible. You can do it in any order. And what you can do is learn a bunch of last layer subsets. And for example, ZBLL, OLCP, or even winter variation. And learn the ones you actually like to use. Like, I learned a bunch of those, like, you know, albs. And I forgot all of them since I didn't like them. So just keep that in mind. And also you can, you know, keep on practicing, you know, look ahead. And also inspection, really important, and learn more F2L algs. And now onto free tips that can really excel this whole process and make you way faster. So first of all, get yourself a timer, okay? So go onto your computer and search up CS timer and bookmark that, and go onto your iOS device and find Chow timer, C-H-A-O, Chow timer, and also download that app, and go onto your Android device and find Keep Timer and download that app. And now you can time yourself, and that's really gonna help you to get way faster. On to the second tip. So for the second tip, you want to get some friends, okay, Cuber friends, and share this video to your Cuber friend and practice together and also compete against each other, okay? And that's gonna really help you to stay competitive and learn fast, okay? So have a bunch of competitions between you and your friends, and that will really excel your learning. And on to number three. Now, join some competitions, okay? When you join competitions, you learn a lot of stuff. You actually meet a bunch of faster people who probably can like tell you guys a lot of things like that you should learn, and you also make more friends and share this video to the friends you make at the competition too. In addition, bonus tip! Focus on F2L. So learn F2L algs, look ahead F2L practice, and also do like inspection, so cross plus F2L, transition, really important stuff, okay? And when you get good at F2L, you can get really good solved. And in fact, if you didn't know all the OLs and PLs, but you had really good F2L, you will still get really good times. So just remember to focus on F2L. That's the whole tutorial. So don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell icon so you don't miss out on all my awesome content. And also share it to your friend so all of you can all improve and become really epic cubers. And this is the Epic Cuber. Bye guys.